Child's play. A massacre!
Wanna go?
Make the... Double kudos! My lab isn't far now. My professor's often said, you're making progress. Now please put down the blowtorch. Nothing to it.
A head without a body. Sure, why not?
From my frame by those nasty Varkids. It's just inside those doors. There's a lever around here somewhere, but until I am reunited with my frame, you will have to be my arms. Excellent work, adventurer. Now, come pick me up. My thanks. Now, after you find my frame, I will regale you with tales of Alkanoth's adventures and the treasure she sought.
Much better. Now, adventurer, heed the call and aid me in finding Alkanoth, Defender of Basarod. Alkanoth the Unfragmented? Nothing? Truly. Why, she is the Typhon de Leon of robotic explorers! In fact, the two led this very expedition together, a rare partnership of bot and human. Long ago, Alkanoth sought the ancient Iridian city of Azamok Mor. although it has been decades since we received her last transmission. I am confident she has noted our presence and is preparing a wondrous celebration of my arrival. Welcoming party. And the door is locked. Well, Alkanos the Reclaimer can't just let anyone into Azamok Moor. A moment, adventurer. Drat. Looks like those nasty bar kids begunked my hover jet. Seek out Alkanos Edition.
Words. Line up three rings and shoot, friend.
Servant has surely noticed our presence and is sending her personal retinue to welcome us to Azamok Moor. And tell Alkanos to send her best medic bots to me, for I am truly begunked.
It's on now. Come on, more, more! Hands.
has unlocked the door as Typhon and Leda made their escape. Forever bonded, buried, using the ring and power coil for Leda, and my exhaust pipe ring for Typhon. Now I expire, so that they may enkindle a light in the dark.
It is done. Alkanost has fallen. A moment, adventurer. I believe I have found you a way out. Return to me. I have something for you.
Wow. I'm telling you, man, one thing goes out and...
Reveal your secrets.
Like, I had to reset the mic. It wasn't... I went through that whole mission talking. And y'all didn't hear shit. That was a nice Lord of the Rings. I was saying that when I walked out. I said, yo, this is giving me Lord of the Rings vibes. And then that's what it was. When as soon as it hit the thing and the skull fell down, I was like, yep, there it is. Then the monstrous, what was it they called him? Barrock. Yo, that was funny, man. This just hasn't been a good day. Well, it seems at least the recording didn't fuck up. Yo, there's a door over there, son. Who texted me, doc?
Iridium. I had hoped it to be an offering to Alkanost and Azamak Moor, but both are lost. What sorrow, what sorrow! All that's left to me now is to seek out the fabled city of Iktok Gofeldor Maroon.
Who?
Surely you've heard of it? No? What sorrow!
One iridium and a blue shotgun. And this makes the game fun, like... I'm gonna have to fight these mofos again.
Feels so good.
Beware the Manrock. Kill the Manrock.
Oh, he's one of them legendary creatures, I guess. Maybe not. Still there.
Absolute massacre.
It's still alive. Oh wow, I didn't notice that. Let me sell this shit. Incoming transition. So I get another legendary one. Yeah. Alright, back on main. buy no ammo, but it's all good. There is a mother sucker up here. I don't know how many of I found. I found two. Or I might have found just one.
Come on, I want the damn challenge.
Okay.
I am the best.
Everything and everyone on Pandora, it seems the elevator to my lab is irrevocably broken. You will need to find another way underground. You're looking for a fuzzy little minecart called Kate. She will show you the way. Brief and tumultuous affair that ended when our tracks went separate ways, as they say. So it goes. Now, caress the minecart. Just trust me on this one. Oh, shut up, Kate.
Nail on the head.
Destroy them! If those things get into my lab, they could damage my precious equipment.
Ha! Down you go!
I knew there was a reason why I didn't use that secondary, because it doesn't hit nothing.
Now stroke my ex once more. Thank you, Tepsu. Now, Vault Hunter, the entrance is just down that corridor. You are nearly there. We'll need to bring it back to Roland's Rest. Disable those couplings to begin preparing it for transport. For the record, I never let anyone inside my lab. But for you, I will make an exception this time. Portrait of Handsome Jack, before he became the torturing, mass-murdering CEO of Hyperion. Back when he was just a coder, a husband, and soon-to-be father of the aforementioned Angel. There's a hidden chamber behind that portrait. You'll have to move it out of the way. Don't worry. That button is perfectly disinfected. I never even touch it with my hands. From our findings in the vault, I believe Sirens are able to imbue memories into physical objects. It may not even be a conscious effort. I recovered one of Angel's childhood toys. Start there. You're looking for a stuffed toy Thracian tetrabear. Just as cuddly as the real thing, minus the neurotoxic claws.
Captain Bear, who is a bear? He is a bear, Captain Bear.
Hey, Angel. Who is this guy?
Captain Bear. He eats crime.
Oh, he must be eating a lot with that big belly, huh? Hey, Angel, darling, what's that on your arm? Did you do that?
Blue. I don't know where it came from. Do you think it's pretty?
Yeah, sweetheart, it's real pretty. Hey, honey, can you get in here for a minute?
I was correct. That was a memory from when Angel's powers first manifested. There are other items she might have interacted with. Look for an old vending machine.
I didn't see you standing there. Don't say any of those words that Daddy said, okay?
Okay. Is the machine broken?
Yeah. Looks like no candy for us. Hey, why don't you go back into the waiting room with Mommy, darling? Huh? The doctor's gonna be here any minute, okay?
I think I can fix it.
What the hell did you just do, Angel?
Like most sirens, it seems using her powers became instinctual soon after acquiring them. She had no concept of what a phase shift even was, only that she could talk to machines, and more importantly, that they listened to her. There should be a turret somewhere in the room. Find that next. It to trigger the memory.
Mommy! Daddy! Help!
Look, you filthy bandit. Just give us back our daughter, okay?
Are you kidding? She's a freaking siren! I'm gonna be a trillionaire! You and your wife get out of here before I sick my turrets on you. Forget the kid. Go make another one.
Girl's scars run deep. There's one more artifact. Look for a Hyperion communication satellite.
Ha!
No can do, my sweet little angel. You're in that chair for your own good, okay?
You're such an asshole!
Language? Look, sweetheart, I can't let you out because of what you did to your mother, okay? I just couldn't bear it if something else happened to you.
I didn't mean to.
Shh, I know, darling. That's why you need to stay in that chair. But I got you something. That chair is connected to the entire Hyperion network. Now you can see through every satellite we own around every planet in the sky. You've got the best view in the whole universe from that chair. We're gonna work together. You and me, kiddo. Sound good?
Yeah. Okay.
I love you, Angel.
I love you too, Dad.
Angel spent most of her life chained to Hyperion technology. With those memories, I think I have enough to fix the water purifier now. Go to Roland's Rest, and I will attempt to interface with it. Amplifier. I believe one of those switches is more than up to the task. Well done! I see why Lilith always sends you to do, well, everything. For now, we can install the amplifier in Roland's Rest. I've already instructed that human sculpture Vaughn to assist you in its transport. You can meet him in the garage downstairs.
Hey, Vault Hunter! So, my head ghost told me to help you drive an Iridium whatever dealie back to Roland's Rest for safekeeping. Still into it. Waiting for you outside. No rush. I got some sweet tunes. Oh yeah, Digby Vermouth! Classic. You ready, bro? Let's do this!
I could listen to Digby Vermouth's velvety tones all day long. But my head lady told me we gotta move this Iridium thing. Oh, fudge pants! The bandits found us! Drive, bro, drive! Spider ants. Hey, you're gonna want to keep your distance. Those things are even uglier on the inside. Long story. Also, smashed spider ants are a bandit delicacy. Just saying. COV! Let's mess them up! Welcome to the danger zone, punks! We gotta fight back! With your foot! Just don't stop! We're hit!
Moving on! Get shot!
Got blasted!
Under control.
We got more company! Keep our cargo safe! Rigs incoming! Danger zone!
Beautiful!
lumps here, Vault Hunter. Whew, nice work. I think we're in the clear. They're shooting at us! Vehicles must die. So says I. Vaughn! Destroy them! Let no vehicle escape our wrath. We got blasted! Almost there! We gotta fight back! Uh-oh, way's blocked. Vault Hunter, shoot that tank! Bro, drive! Warpath! We made it! My blood is pumping! I love this planet! Go, Sun Smashers! I mean, Crimson Raiders!
Woohoo! Ah, home crap home.
Executing phase shift. Makes much more sense now. Angel's memories did indeed contain the information I required. It seems the Hyperion water purifier had a planned obsolescence chip inside it. I'll simply override it, and we can be done with this water chip nonsense. We did it, Vault Hunter! And all it took was reliving the traumatic childhood of a fallen angel. Let Vaughn know his water purifier is working once again.
Vault Hunter, bro. I gotta say, I've been on a lot of crazy road trips, but your driving skills, they're tasty, bro. They're tasty! So, if you wanna ride sometime, you just let me know, bro. Bro trip! Whoa, sorry. I got a little carried away there. Anyway, we'll guard the Iridium flippity-flu and rally the troops. When Lilith gives the word, it's go time. Oh, can you ask the lady ghost head friend to stay out of my head from 8 to 11? That's where I keep the special thoughts. You got the water working again! That's awesome! Water slide city, baby! Ooh, slick, wet, shiny, glisteny. Oh yeah, also, no one's dying of thirst, so that's pretty good too.
Okay, Tanis' Iridium amplifier is in place, and Vaughn's forces on the ground are at the ready. We're not gonna get a better chance to move on the Calypsos.
Incoming transmission!
The Calypsos, got it. That should be interesting.
Hey, turd farmers! Check this out! take a look out the window. Troy's about to blow your spine out, giraffe.
Everyone all right?
Aye, but how did you, like, phase lock the entire moon? Wow.
What the hell is going on?
It's the freaking moon, you idiots! The key to the Great Vault has been in front of your dumb faces this whole time.
See, I was planning to leech enough vault monsters to charge it myself, but then you handed us your stupid siren friend, and now Troy can just use Iridium.
Once I charge Opus, the Great Vault will open.
I'll leech the monster inside, and we become gods!
We'd invite you to our place for the grand opening, but, it's kind of a family thing.
See you at the end of the world!
I'm doomed! Unless... is it too late to join the COV?
Get it together, Claptrap!
Lilith, we must stop Troy from opening the Great Vault, but as long as he's infusing himself with Iridium, he will be nearly invincible. Then we cut off his supply. Vault Hunter, once Tanis takes out those turrets, you lead a ground assault.
With pleasure.
And whoever has a death wish can take on Tyrene and Troy.
Ooh, also me.
Ava, you good to back up the Vault Hunter?
Yeah. You sure?
You were right. We gotta run towards the fire. Let's go, everyone. Vault Hunter, get geared up and say your goodbyes. This is it. Talk to me before you head down there, killer.
Is this what you do for fun? Loiter?